The following program is a production of HEW Entertainment and contains views, opinions, commentaries, and content that may offend some subscribers of this show. Listener discretion is advised.
It's that time once again for HEW Entertainment Radio.
And that's all I got to say about that.
Hosted by Jonathan Clark.
The Beat! The Man!
You gotta be the man!
Whoa!
Be sure to join us in the live chat room during the show.
Hulkamania is running wild like it's never ran before.
Call us on one of our request lines. If you live in the United States, call us at 1-641-985-7800, box number 3729288. If you're from Canada and would like to call us from 1-647-724-4194, box number 3729288. Long-distance charges may apply in some areas.
I've been the World Heavyweight Champion 10 times.
Or you can always drop us a line at MySpace, myspace.com/HEW Entertainment.
And you will rest in peace.
Emailing us works for you too. Email us HEWWrestling@hotmail.com.
I am a wrestling god.
J.B.L. J-B-L.
And now, without any further ado, here is your host of HEW Entertainment Radio on the official website of HEW Entertainment, Jonathan Clark.
The champ is here!
HEW Entertainment Radio is inviting you to comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
Comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
So what are you waiting for? Log on and listen now.
Don't miss out on any of the action. Download our app on the App Store, Google Play, and the official website of HEW Entertainment. Once you've downloaded and installed it, you'll get caught up on news, YouTube videos, and more. Download it now.
What the fuck? What the fuck? What the fuck?
You got me sipping on something I can't compare to nothing I've ever known. I'm hoping that after this fever I'll survive. I know I'm acting a bit crazy, strung out a little bit hazy. Hand over heart, I'm praying that I'm gonna make it out alive. The bed's getting cold and you're not here. The future that we hold is so unclear. But I'm not alive until you call. And now but the odds against it all. And screaming, lighting me up like Venus. But then you disappear and make me wait. And every second's like torture. Heroin drip, no more so. Finding a way to let go. Baby, baby, no, I can't escape. The bed's getting cold and you're not here.
Oh,
Selena Gomez is back and sounds a lot better than what she did when she was with Justin Bieber. Following their breakup, she came out with that single. It's called The Heart Wants What It Wants. The video for it is on our Facebook page at HEW Entertainment and on Twitter at Jonathan Clark. One, I gotta give it up to Selena Gomez for all the songs she's been putting out on syndicated radio. She's got a new one called Good For You. That's a great slow one featuring some backup Selena Gomez gets in the song. She also gets some backup from one of her newer ones called I Want You to Know from Zedd. That combination, really big fan of that. And that one, of course, one of the first songs she came out with following her breakup with Justin Bieber, which of course was focused on by the media so much it was blown entirely out of proportion. What's interesting about that song, The Heart Wants What It Wants, there's an interesting monologue dropped prior to the song kicking off where Selena Gomez talks about a lot of regrets she had with Justin Bieber and some of the mistakes she made. But despite all the regrets that she came away from the relationship with and all the mistakes that she has made, she has come back better than ever and is on top of the Billboard chart with artists like Zedd helping her out with some of her newer songs. And I got to give Selena Gomez the benefit of the doubt and credit where credit is definitely due for coming back stronger than she ever has before. The new one, Good For You, we're going to be getting that on our show very soon for you, so keep listening for that one. Really like the slow song where she talks about just wanting to look good for a guy that she's in love with and infatuated with. Great messages coming from Selena Gomez, and I think that will indicate a promising future for her coming up over the next 6 months through the next year. It's going to be really interesting to find out where she goes from here on out. If you've got a file on Selena Gomez, an opinion you'd like to throw our way, you can leave it for me in the comments of this video at JonathanClark22. You can tweet me on Twitter at JonathanClark1. You can leave it for me on my Facebook page at HEW Entertainment, because I know the Selena Gomez fans are out there by the millions. And there are supporters of Selena Gomez coming in all the time on social media, raising conversation about what Selena Gomez has been up to. I have been a victim of questioning the direction of Selena Gomez more times than often on this radio show and video blogs, on my YouTube channel, in the audio archives of my radio form, on my website, on the podcast, of course, over on podnova.com. I've questioned Selena Gomez's choices in both her personal life and her professional career, but even though I do question a lot of things that Selena Gomez was doing, I wanted to give her the benefit of the doubt and everything that I was questioning with what she was doing in her personal life and her career, and I don't want to question it anymore because I think that it's more certain now what she is trying to do. She's trying to rehabilitate herself and come back better than she ever has before. After taking a break, she tried a hand at being a director for Wizards of Waverly Place, The Wizard's Return in 2013, which was a great Disney Channel original movie starring Selena Gomez and some of the original cast members of Wizards of Waverly Place, and then she came out with all these singles, getting millions of downloads on iTunes, so I don't question Selena Gomez's choices in her personal life and her professional career. In the way of professionality, I think that Selena Gomez has exemplified a tremendous amount of professionality, and that's more than what I can say for Justin Bieber and so many other celebrities who have fallen victim to this sort of thing with depression and different circumstances that have arisen in their personal lives. Some celebrities go away. Some celebrities take it a little bit too far. We know, for instance, what happened with Miley Cyrus in 2013, that album Bangers, an entirely different perception and image, along with a message coming from Miley Cyrus saying she didn't care what anyone, the fans, the media, thought of her, and she just revolted in such an unprofessional way. Even though she had a great deal of success with Banger, she just did it so unprofessionally, like many celebrities in her category have done. But Selena Gomez, along with Demi Lovato and Taylor Swift, doing a great job with their characters, their images, their distribution, and I think that their images and their characters, their distribution, have been phenomenally distributed by their producers, their record label. It's amazing, and I got to give everybody the benefit of the doubt who's assisted Selena Gomez in getting past everything that's gone on in her personal life with Justin Bieber, who refuses to talk about a lot of stuff. He's starting to comment on some stuff, though, in interviews now after coming back from rehab and dealing with what's going on in his personal life. He was very unprofessional a couple of years ago. When he would actually be questioned about Selena Gomez, he would actually walk off interviews for some of them that I saw on YouTube. Actually, during the recording of the interview for a YouTube video, Justin Bieber would walk off more than one interview that I saw on YouTube, so that's more than what I can say for him. It seems like Selena Gomez definitely rebounded and turned her life around a lot quicker than what Justin Bieber did following their breakup. And I remember reading so many magazine articles the year that it was announced that Selena Gomez and Justin Bieber were actually together, and I thought to myself, you know, they look great in magazine articles. They look great for the tabloids, and the media just had something to get a whole lot of different juice from with Selena Gomez and Justin Bieber. They were looking for something to get a lot of juice squeezed out of, and that relationship definitely within the first year was something for magazine articles, columnists, of course, radio show hosts to be all over for video blogs on YouTube. I know fans were throwing up their opinions, and girls actually were threatening Selena Gomez on Twitter, saying that if she ever hurt Justin Bieber, they were